Thank you. Good morning. We'd like to welcome you all here today. We are ready to begin the ceremony, so thank you for being here. Kehet. Thank you. Please remain standing. Thank you.
Good morning.
Yad Ebene, Che Sir Nasal Inisha, Kitishini Nishna, but Adi Bashishi, Vilagana Dashate, Nada Lugay Nasteji Tabaha Dashanele. Good morning and welcome to our class 2022's graduation. Leona Gilmore. And we will also have the national anthem done in sign language by one of our young future Mustangs, Arabella Peshlicky.
Thank you.
would like to introduce Mr. Ollie Whaley to do our invocation. So would you please remove your caps in honor of this, our prayer?
So begins it.
We taught me as a young God, the Gospel of the Lord. Care and quest, I'm not listening to me. We call me our chain. And so I can't do not look at them. That is how I keep out of the news and even the death. It's not that same thing. We call me our chain, that is how I need to talk. That is how your tough bond sick has more tough your day mean me. Your time has done me now. The cause of sagging has its father. But Tana has coyoted their sling. But what had an reason? Though they come, Kayla Carcadoe to the United States of America, yay. Bahaya dan insan, nah berkecil pun dah left door, ni nak tani kita pun dah left. Kalau ikon, dia never kira dia also ini. Nah stop bahaya dan insan, konde, on kini, host saya tobe dan hoye, now dah tingkat, asal deh.
So I would like to thank, the class of 2020 would like to thank, to acknowledge the Indian Education Committee members who have gone beyond their duties to assist our students with the following: caps, gowns, tassels, traditional clothing outfits, college tour trips, t-shirts, lace, gift bags, glasses, and especially the soles of the graduating class of 2020. So I would like to recognize Miss Judy Francis, Sheila Pelt, Carly Begay, and Charlotte Joe. Would you guys please come up and receive a gift from the class of 2020?
Good morning. Congratulations, it's nice to see that this building's open for graduation. I'm very happy that we're here to just watch the graduation today. I will introduce the initiative. She Judy Sales Francis, the student, and the Hanavani Bashish Chin, Hachini, Edashin Cheda, Beshin, Edashinal, and the Aya Shichon, the Dohana, Aya Franklin W. Yazil, Yan Eko, 1973, and the Aya Ashchi, the Nandokia, Ani, the Nandosha, the Halia, and the Shah, Shachin, Dohano, Ekenaki. I have five grandkids and two great grandsons, Aro Shamaya Catherine Sales and my late grandfather, my father Francis Sales, then I represent Shichimito chapter, it's under Johnson O'Malley. It's a federal funded program which provides supplemental educational program activity for Native American students attend public school and private school. That funding serves 27 schools on Navajo reservation. It was passed back in
to start off our ceremony, I would like to introduce one of my fellow best friends since birth, and one of my upper officers to do our welcome address. Please welcome Melindy Harvey.
I am the student council president and serve 3 years as the cost officer. Hello, good morning, fellow peers, parents, guardians, teachers, faculty, superintendent, board members, MVHS alumni, and other visiting dignitaries. Welcome to the class of 2022 graduation ceremony. If there are any MVHS alumni, please stand and be recognized. We are gathered here today to celebrate the achievements of these honorable individuals. Individually, each and every one of us has something to be proud of, whether it be in academics, sports, leadership, and many other notable categories. Some of us are graduating in the top 10 of our class. Some of us have been selected to be the best athletes on the Navajo Nation, and some of us have prestigious scholarships or scholarships in general under our belts. Graduating, for one, is something to be proud of. Graduation is one of the many milestones you'll hit in life. These past 4 years of my life, I've learned things can happen unexpectedly and opportunities can be lost. I'm sure we have all had rough time throughout the years. We didn't have a normal experience, to say the least, but considering we're all here today says a lot about ourselves. Personally, I believe that with the help of this great community and this place as a whole, I couldn't have done it without the undying support. This place holds a special place in my heart and forever will. When it came to playing sports, our fans and community that stood behind us were a huge part of our success this year. I will always remember playing at the first rounds at the volleyball state tournament this past year. All you heard and saw were Mustang fans. They were always the loudest in the gyms, and the crowd were always a red FC. So with this, thank you for giving me and each and every one of these people sitting before me a huge amount of endless support. Can we please give our community a round of applause? I will be attending Northern Arizona University, pursuing a degree in physical therapy. As for the rest of us, it will be going straight into the workforce, military, or going back to school. I wish you all the best of what comes next. Again, congratulations to the class of 2022, and thank you to those who are joining us today, and those who are viewing online. Thank you.
Now I'd like to welcome up one of my other fellow officers and best friends to do the recognition of KUSD administrators and governing board members. Please welcome Kaylee Cascoli. I will now be introducing our board members and administrators. Today we have Vice Principal Mr. Douglas South, Principal Mr. Blaine Baker, Mr. Steve Young, our athletic coordinator, Superintendent Lemuel Axon, board members Patricia Parrish, our motivational speaker Shandine Herrera, Mr. Whaley, our weight training teacher, our motivational speaker Shandine Herrera, and our class of 2022 sponsor, Mrs. Elaine Sombrero. And our board members that aren't present today, but Roy Lee, Lisa Granado, Dr. James Niss, Ashin Ashaw Osho.
find them.
Before I get started, I would like to ask Mr. Charlie C. Billy to stand alongside me while I read. Anthony Harrison, Yinisha, Itaki Ninchlet, Eshia Bashichi, Klaus Chi, Deshiche, Tobaha, Deshnilin. Good morning, everyone. I hope everybody today is having a blessed morning as we're all here today to celebrate a memorable achievement. Behind me today stands the world's largest Navajo woven rug. Chochimito is the proud home of the artistic masterpiece which exemplifies the traditional weaving talent of the Navajo woman. In the small community, the rug measures 25 feet in width by 39 feet in height. It took 11 women 2 years from 1977 to 1979 to weave the magnificent rug. The rug is an offering of the respect and honor not only to the Navajo woman, but the mythological spider woman, who blessed the Navajo people with the gift of weaving. Chochimito is the Navajo phrase whose literal translation is the myth of sumac bushes and water. The principal artistic who wove the largest hand-woven masterpiece was Superintendent Helen Charlie, Kate Lee Charlie, Jane H. Charlie, Bessie Red Mustache, Helen Begay, Rose Austin, Joanne Singer, Susie Young, Lily Yazzie, Lita Keith, and Louise Charlie. Mr. Tom Yazzie was a daily manual help who tightened the loom upon needed. These 11 ladies who were selected to work on the rug from start to finish were very traditional because of their upbringing, and they had no formal schooling in their lives. Yet they were highly interested, competitive, knowledgeable, skillful, and talented. Each of the fundamental knowledgeable of weaving and many years of weaving experience that it took them. That is my speech. Thank you.
Motivational speaker come up. But before we do that, we would like to introduce her, and the introduction of our motivational speaker will be done by one of my other fellow officers and best friends, Adriana Kutzo. Yata Bene, She Abriana Clitza Yamashia, Tibichi Ningashle, Hanawati Bushes Chi, Tolhan and Dashachi, Dashanella, or Ashihin Dashanella. It is an honor for me to introduce today's guest speaker, an alumni from Monument Valley High School, class of 2015, and an alumni from Duke University, class of 2019. Please help me welcome Shandine Herrera. Yat and Shikado Shidine, She A Shadine Herrera Yinishia, Nadina Shlashinakai, Tachini Nishle, Nakai Doshishin, but Anita Shiche, Nakai Doshinele.
Ye ha unido Navajo and Hopi Families COVID-19 Relief Fund, E banashnish. First of all, I would like to say congratulations to all of our graduates. 7 years ago, I stood in this very position delivering my speech as senior class president. Though I have no idea what I said, I remember how I felt. Excited, proud, and a little bit nervous about what lies ahead after walking across this stage to receive my diploma. I'm sure all of you are feeling one or more of these emotions right now. Graduating from high school is a milestone, the closing of one chapter and the opening of a brand new one. Each of you will leave here today feeling accomplished and ready for what's to come next. As I reflected on my time here at MVHS, I realized how essential this community has been in shaping my character, challenging my weaknesses, and reminding me of my why. In 2015, I graduated, packed my bags, and moved across the country to North Carolina. In Durham, North Carolina, I joined a brilliant community of scholars and some pretty talented basketball players, if you're asking me, at my dream school, Duke University. I often felt ostracized and questioned my own ability to fit in that environment. In those challenging moments, when I felt homesick, when I felt insignificant, I remembered this. I remembered our community, and the many people in my corner supporting me and believing in me before I believed in myself. Instead of trying to fit in at Duke, I decided to stand out. And as our former First Lady, Michelle Obama, put it, I decided to work until my weaknesses became my strengths. In 2019, I walked across the stage and received my bachelor's from the Sanford School of Public Policy. I was the 2019 Terry Sanford Leadership Award winner, an award to a graduating senior that demonstrated exceptional leadership in their time at Duke. In my kenza, turquoise, and dress Shema made me, I proudly accepted my award. I was described as having outrageous ambition. Of course, as the overthinker I can be, I thought to myself, outrageous. Why was it so outrageous for a Navajo woman to challenge an institution like Duke to demand the same level of respect and support that our non-Indigenous students enjoyed? Why was it so outrageous for me to excel in an environment that was not built for me, and in fact, was built to break me down? However, what Duke didn't know is that as Diné, we know how to persist, adapt, and excel. As you leave the reservation, enter new spaces of education and professions, remember that when people see you, they see us, our entire community. It is a big weight to carry, but if you allow it to be, it can be the greatest honor. To me, knowing that I'm representing all of us, my family, my friends, Shidine, makes me courageous. I left Duke feeling empowered and strong enough to come home. Growing up, I was always told that I had potential. I'm sure all of you hear that all the time, right? I had potential to be a great student, a great candidate for scholarships, and even potential to get into a top 10 university. I'm sure many of you have your own lists of potentials and expectations. Somewhere along the way, this potential trickled over into ideas of success. Very early in my life, I knew that I wanted to be successful, even if I didn't quite understand what success truly is. I knew that I wanted to make my family, my community proud, and I wanted to honor the sacrifices of my ancestors who endured much work so that I could be here today, living, breathing, and dreaming in Dineta. My early ideas of success were shaped mostly by the expectations projected onto me by my teachers, community members, and adults in my life. Success meant leaving the res and obtaining a quality education and creating an entire life for myself. This idea of success was linear, seemingly attainable, but definitely easier said than done. As I moved through my college years, I felt myself yearning to be home. Food trucks in Durham reminded me of our Wednesday flea markets. The dirt roads I walked on to work while living abroad in Cusco, Peru, made me miss Sevilla's sky even more. And working in Washington, D.C., writing memos about our land and our people made me miss Dineta. My biggest fear was that somehow coming home meant that I failed. I began wondering why we as a nation continue to send our brightest scholars and our hardest workers away on a one-way ticket. Why do we teach our children that their talent is only deemed successful if manifested off the reservation? I don't have the answers, and I'm not sure anyone does, but I knew that despite what was expected of me, I needed to follow my heart. My heart led me home. If I'm being honest, my journey back to the reservation was more difficult than my journey off the res. But I have always lived my life knowing that if I follow my heart, my mind will follow, and that any challenge that arises is worth it if it meant I got to wake up every morning in Dineta. Being secure and knowing who I am, and even if I didn't have a plan for what my career or life would look like, I've always maintained a vision for myself. I also have had to completely redefine what success meant for me and figure out who I am as a Dineta Stump. So, instead of asking myself, what am I going to do? I began asking myself, who can I be and how do I become this person? My biggest challenge was actually not navigating college and being away from home. It was putting more energy into my own dreams and manifesting a vision for myself rather than trying to meet the expectations others had for me. Not only was I able to return home immediately after graduating from Duke, but I was extremely fortunate to be proximate to my family and my community when the COVID-19 pandemic started. Now, I am a believer that everything happens for a reason. And my experience working throughout the pandemic almost seemed serendipitous, but I knew that I was home for a reason. And this reason was to step forward and protect our community. In March of 2020, I joined 12 Navajo and Hopi women and co-founded the Navajo and Hopi Families COVID-19 Relief Fund. We had one goal, protect our people from COVID. Through crowdfunding and donations, we were able to raise over $18 million and provide direct support to families throughout the Navajo Nation and Hopi Reservation. From food and PPE distributions to hauling wood and water for families, I experienced an entirely new level of care and what it truly meant to show up for our people. I have had the honor of working alongside an incredibly selfless team, and throughout the last few years, I have truly grown into the person I have always wanted to be, brave, kind-hearted, and altruistic. This is my story and my success. Not leaving the res, not excelling in college, not the awards and the recognitions, but taking all of my small wins and paving a pathway home. My final question is, what is your idea of success? Redefining success meant untangling a childhood of insecurity and embracing my personal dreams of community development. Each of you has it within your power to write your own story and define what success means for you. I want to remind you that every day begins and ends with you. So do what makes you happy and do what makes you proud. Start each day with the intention to help one person, even if that one person is you. As you continue your journey through education, leadership, career, and personal growth, remember to always take care of yourself. Surround yourself not with people who drain you, but with people who support you and uplift you. Whether you leave here today top of your class or relieved you somehow made it to graduation day, know that your journey matters. And whether you realize it today or not, you are an inspiration. You've managed to remain dedicated to your future, even amidst a global pandemic. I know I can speak for everyone here when I say, we are in awe of your determination and perseverance that each of you have showcased. After years of being unable to convene in person, being here with all of you is truly a blessing. I hope all of you enjoy each other's company and the celebrations with your families. I wish each of you nothing but the absolute best in your endeavors. I'm really excited to see the incredible opportunities you will pursue. I would like to end by saying thank you. Thank you to our parents, our grandparents, teachers, bus drivers, cafeteria cooks, administrators, and everyone who played a vital role in supporting our youth. This is also a moment for all of you to celebrate. As you receive your diploma and enter your next chapter, always remember, and you can say this part with me, once a Mustang, always a Mustang. Yeah. Wow, let's get a little round of hand applause for Shawnee. On behalf of the class of 2022, we would like to present her a gift for our appreciation for her coming out and talking to us and giving her insights of what it's like growing up on the reservation and leaving to pursue an education. Thank you. Now we will have the recognition of top 10. This will be done by Ms. Marita Draper and Jason Franklin, presenting awards to the top 10 students of our graduating class.
Gat Eben, Ado Shadana, Shea Marina Draper, Yisha, Shin, Shon, Tohat, Lady Bashashi, Kitachin, Dash, Shake, Hanamahi, Dashanet, Such Nisho, Sinasha, Shimato, Shaja, Aya, Rose, Doll, Paul, Sales, and again. Quiet for Nesh, Jay, Otahas, and Nastase Ada, Shanaka, Manishon, Adon, the Quiet, Potal, Taye, Aya, Katch, A condition for an life tie had not hit the hot ocean of the nation. I don't want the Sando touch none nor eight in Danish for Mr. Brian Bradley and Michelle Tolicini. The question that has Tanigi last eight, the Yota Ada and Tani, a chimney of Danish of Ness Nahi. It died of us of the chin, Hashin and Fiji.
These are the 10 students with the highest GPA in the graduating class of 2022. Andrew Shepherd. That's my quarterback. Ebriana Klitzo. Adriana Benal. Candace Singer. Alyssa Sombrero. Ayana Nash. Chaslyn Curley. Salute. salutatorian for the class of 2022, Sri Yazi. The valedictorian for the class of 2022, Ashanti Nez.
Now I would like to welcome up our IEC President, Judy Francis, to give a few words.
Not a hit, no, I would have a talk. darle el evangelio a los hombres. Lo que te chida, hey, algo de Hamasando, che, en la skin, ella, ojos, hace, algo Hamado, ocho, en los Sanja, Hamado, Jose, Jose, Eva, Tha, Ada, Josie, Sto, Jim, Sakes, y Jim, Daza, Ashi, Nazna, Leye, Yayas, Tiron, Jonia, that is, I just pick it up from other people, Yayas, Tis, and Ashley, and then that's how I talk and do my speech. Hey there, yeah, I'm an analogic nation, and thank you for letting me have this, to do another speech up here. Thank you, Hat.
Now we will have our salutatorian address, but I would like to say a few words about her. I've known her since, oh my god, since like elementary school.
Ew.
But, and I've seen her grow, and oh my gosh, she's like super smart. Like, yeah. And then she's really, I don't know. I mean, she has really made a big impact on my life, and I'm glad that she's still in it, but, I would like to introduce Sri Yazi.
Good morning, fellow students, family, friends, faculty, and especially good morning to the graduating class of 2022. My name is Sri Yazi, and it is my distinct honor to be addressing you all here today. When I was told I was to be giving this speech, I was super excited for like a minute, and I was like, I'm going to be giving a speech. And I was so scared. I thought so long and hard about what I was going to say, and just like all my other assignments, I actually wrote the speech last night. And if I'm being completely honest, I finished it this morning, about 15 minutes before we came out here. So just bear with me as I read it here for the first time. Now, these past few years have been nothing short of crazy. And by crazy, I mean crazy crazy. It is said that we've experienced a decade worth of events over the course of 2 years. The year 2020 alone will have its own chapter in history textbooks. It amazes me as I reminisce when we were innocent freshmen taking our first steps into the building, blissfully unaware of how these next 4 years would treat us. And then all of a sudden, having our entire student lifestyles flipped upside down as we entered a worldwide pandemic. I feel as though our experience here at Monument Valley High School has been none like any other that past generations just can't compare. It felt like we learned a lot during this time, but looking back, we actually gained a lot. We did learn something. The teachers had to up their tech skills. We as students had to really learn how to pay attention in our new classrooms, whether it was in our bedrooms, in the kitchen, at grandma's, or McDonald's parking lot. We learned to continue our education, even though we weren't physically near each other. I do admire those that were really challenged. Those that didn't have that infrastructure, that didn't have that home setting, or maybe they were the ones who had to travel just to get some sort of reception or signal. We all became stronger in this way. Some, if you guys didn't know, were even doing classwork by packets. They were the ones that really had the challenge because they had to learn it all on their own. They were without a teacher and they couldn't watch it on Zoom, so their parents, grandmas, or guardians were forced to become teachers for them. Or maybe they were their own problem solvers. And for this, can we please give them a round of applause? We made it, we're here now, we fulfilled our course requirements, and now, even though we're not sure what's ahead of us, just know that we made it. We have the strength from that experience to help us move forward to whatever life has ahead of us. Oh, I just want to encourage you, my fellow classmates, that we can accomplish a lot if we draw upon our experiences, whether they were negative or positive, they were meant to strengthen us. Don't give up, just like we didn't give up during that time, let's not give up when we're faced with whatever it is that comes our way. I could go on and talk about the mental health side of the whole staying at home phase, but I'm traumatized. Though, I am going to miss seeing everyone in school and on Zoom. Whether it was a picture of your face, Amy, or even that moment when you have your mic on and you can hear your mom yelling at you to do the dishes. And yet, here we all sit, ready to take on the next phase of our lives, almost as if we didn't experience a decade worth of events. We're optimistic, happy even. We can all agree that this class is resilient, and the fact that we made it here, decorated with these awards and accomplishments, is just a testament to our perseverance and commitment to exercise. And don't get me wrong, this past year alone had many highlights as well. We got our volleyball and football team taking the 3A North title in the fall. And the boys basketball and boys and girls wrestling team taking it as well in the winter. We have coped with and overcome our challenges with humor and love, two keys that make our generation distinct. But if there's one thing that we have learned here in PHS, it is to take pride in who we are and wherever we are, whether it was on the field, the classroom, or here in the Nash, cheering as loud as we can as we lost our voices. Mustangs are always the loudest and proudest group of people, and you can always count on that. Or Keegan over here. Thankful is an understatement, but I am thankful for those who guided me. My mom, my dad, my sisters, and grandparents. I could always count on them, and to my parents, Sharon and Kelly Ozzie over there, somewhere. Thank you for everything. I was actually on varsity for volleyball, basketball, and softball since my freshman year, and we traveled a lot, of course, and I just remember always looking into the stands and seeing them there, and they have gone to every single one of my games, whether it was home or away, and I could just always count on them to be there. They were there when we almost beat the number one team in state for volleyball, one of the best games I've ever played here. They were there when we beat Snowflake in their gym to advance in the second round of state for basketball. And they were there when we played Alchester State for softball. It went 10 innings. It was like the longest game ever, but probably the most exciting. I'm also going to miss that moment when my parents would drop me off in the morning and they'd play like some random kids pop song and blast it while I get out of the car. And to my coaches in NBHS athletics, Tina, thank you for help shaping me into the person I am today. Athletics taught me discipline, dedication, work ethic, time management, how important it is to have confidence, to communicate, and that on time is late and 10 minutes early is on time. I think street poet and philosopher Drake put it best when he said, "Oh well, I guess you lose some and win some, as long as the outcome is income." While the idea of material success influences our lives heavily, I ask that you follow your dreams and do what makes you happy. Strive to be the best version of yourself and live life. Congratulations again, class of 2022. Sure,
Now I would like to take the time to recognize the most valuable member of our graduating class, our valedictorian, Ashanti Nez. Good morning, everyone. How's everybody doing? I know you're all nervous, but I just want to remind you guys that you guys did this and you guys deserve this. Okay? I'm proud of y'all. Genuinely. Okay. I would like to thank all the parents and teachers for attending this graduation ceremony today, as well as to our senior class officers and Miss Imbro for organizing it all. Can we have a round of applause for them? For I am thankful for my mother, Dorothy Thomas, and my older siblings, my brothers, Ricky Dash Chibi and Antonio Nez, and my older sister, Vicky Dash Chibi, who has helped me to this position over the years. I would also like to thank the faculty members within the school, along with my teachers, who either wrote me recommendations or were just there to guide me through the best path. Mrs. Bradley, Mr. Franklin, Mr. and Mrs. McBride, and Mr. Gilmore. Thank you. But today, I am the most thankful for myself, as I am standing here as valedictorian of class of 2022. Over the four short years I toiled in high school, I have seen many faces of the seniors that you see sitting here before you today grow into their own distinguished selves. For the parents sitting in the crowds, you should be proud of your child. And when this ceremony is over, I want you to tell them in the exact words that you are proud of them, because they deserve it. For they have earned that praise, and them sitting here is proof that they will be going on to greater things their paths lead them to pursue. Because believe it or not, the class of 22 has been through many endeavors. Whether it has been losing a family member, dealing with mental illness, financial issues, COVID, or just having to experience negative put-downs by loved ones. We all have dealt with a great deal that has shaped us into who we are today, which leads us to where we are standing now. Graduating in the great Nash Gym, where others have become alumni before us. As an individual, I am no different than any other. Don't let this position where I am standing fool you for perfection. Don't even compare this position to your child, because they deserve the same praise that you are all giving me. I am still a student who still has to deal with life. After all, I am human, I am not perfect, and I have my strengths and I have my limits. I want to say that I'm a first generation post-secondary student, the second in my family to go to college after high school, and I am Stanford bound. And many others here had greater advantages than I, more than I could ever count, and yet here I am. But great guidance from the school's faculty has been very helpful. And out of the memories I have made during the 4 years here, I will never forget the feeling I felt when I first transferred here. Being in a new environment with new faces, rebuilding relationships, and overcoming the challenges, I was overwhelmed to the point where the first week I had cried every day at home saying, I don't want to go to school here. And for that, I was wrong. I was wrong for judging the people here without knowing them. Until one day,
I realized that the only way to overcome this huge challenge was to pull myself together, because I understood that no one is going to do it for me. Not my mom, not my brother, not my sister, no. I had to do it. And that was one lesson my mother has taught over the years to me and my siblings. You have to do it yourself. And this motto will always humble me in the hardest times. And in the end, I met some of the greatest people ever. I met Mr. and Mrs. McBride in FFA. I met an esteemed student body leader with Ms. Sequoia. I saw new distances with Upward Bound and National Honor Society. But most of all, I've met a group of future successful individuals all within the last 4 years. And with that, I would like to shout out to some people who are sitting here today. Andrea, you're my right-hand man. Terry, you're my sugar mommy forever. Clarissa, I'll always be here to give you a hug, always. Mayuri, you will always crack me up. And I hope to always be there for you as well. Kaden, I'll certainly miss your sarcasm. Kiki, we better be wearing the same shirts the next time we meet. Joanne, your hairline are my goals. I really want to have that. Strand, we should make some art in the future. Charmaine, let's go to a BTS concert sometime. And Devon, you could never pass my PR. Anyways. Lastly, to Mr. Franklin, I will always miss your sarcastic and humorous remarks in class. And that is all. But in the end, I just want to say, class of 22, I'm so proud of you, and you did this. Yeah. And before I get off stage, can I have a selfie? That's okay with you guys? Yeah?
The reader of our class, Brian Begay.
Candace Singer. Andrew Shepherd. Caden Draper. Tree Yazzie. Serena Salt. Kaylee Kiskoli. Adriana Clitzo. Melindy Harvey. Ayana Nash. Sharnisty Holiday. Terry Anna Lucky Jack. Leona Gilmore. Chaslyn Curley. Ashanti Nez. Alyssa Sombrero. Adriana Benali. Woodrow Hott. Coulter Begay. Skylin Flores. Anthony Harrison. May Holmes. Charmaine Begay. Mariah Begay. Kiera Chief. Joanne Salt. Andrea Holliday. Mayuri Plummer. Ryan Stanley. Strand Frank. Xavier Sombrero. Kiki Mayava. Autumn Sky. Cordell McGee. Brandon Yellowman. Sherilyn Reddye. Garrett Totachini. Romeo the Net Deal. Genova Madison. Kristen Sherlock. Raina Zani. Shayla Paiochi. Tylen Smith. Espen Zafir Tanakhagwa. Peyton Riggs. Kaden Key. Hope Murphy. Vernon Begay. Malcolm. Malachi Yazzie. Racy Blackrock. Angel Holiday. Romello Nettles. Jamal Williams. Caden Kiskoe. Lyle Blackgoat. Jameis Joe. Jennifer Elcock. Darnell Johnson. Daisha Harrell. Clarissa Bedoni. Deshae Clyde. Michaela Tonicini. Ezekiel Chorty. Gavin Spencer. Aaron Perez. Emily Salt. Angel Shaw. Paisley Curlyhair. Kaya Goto. Blaine Begay. Kevin James. Cash Blackrock. Devon Corbin. Tyson Ateen. Justin Parrish. Christy Danesosi. Tristana Seaton. Brianna Alcock. Reese Begay. Dwayne Bailey. Lethan Stanley. Linnea Watson. Ethan Small Canyon. Keyshawn Green. Jolene Charlie. Ayana Bedoni. Teola Blackwater. Daquan Mitchell. Correa Dugat. Tyvin Dugat. Natalia Salt. Shyla McGay. Kylie Tom. Carmen Lee. Braden McGay. Spencer Black. Lori Lee Begay. Brandy Gillis. Stephen Hale. Danielle Bizzardi. Javante Curry. Sheridan Curley. Adrian Nelson. JC Berlin. Archelaus Yazzie. Letitia Stanley. Alfonso Trixie. Sean Davis. Marcus Montoya. Navani Gray. Kiana Nez. Jasmine Grisham. Aaron Minigoats. Elijah Little. Michaela Glasses. Javier Sheen. Rachel Begay. Christina Yazzie. Jamie Begay. Leah Begay. Skylar Hurley. Owen Holmes. Elijah Woolboy. Grant Yazzie. Blue Sky White. Trevin Riggs.
Now we will do the tassel part of our graduation, the most exciting part. Now I'd like to welcome up Tariana Lillijack, Dequan Mitchell, and Gracie Blackrock up to the stage.
say now put your tassel from the right to the left. Yadesh, Gay, Nosh, and Tanet, Shane, Chasm, Curly, and Isha, Twa, Han, and Nishnik, Namaste, Zazava, Amashashi, Tuna, Kuja, Dash, Jay, Tulichini, Dash, Nell, Shema, Dosh, Jay, A, Adrian, John, Do, Mile, Curly, Shema, Sunna, Dosh, Jay, A, Lady, Young, Do, Anton, John, Shema, Shanella, Stamp, Dosh, Nana, Sin, A, Lily, Curly, Do, Mark, Curly, Wobbly, and Dan. Good morning, family, friends, faculty in the class of 2022. My name is Chaslyn Curley. I was your student council executive vice president and will be MII High School alumni at Stanford University. First of all, congratulations to all the graduates and to your loved ones who are celebrating with you today and who will cheer you on to your next step, or next chapter. Here's a favorite quote of mine. There is a universal truth we all have to face, whether we want to or not. Everything eventually ends. As much as I've looked forward to this day, I've always disliked endings. Last day of summer, the chapter of a great book, and parting ways with a close friend. But endings are inevitable. Leaves fall and you close the book. You say goodbye. Today is one of those days for us. End quote, Alexis Castle. Now I would like for parents, guardians, family, and KUSC staff to stand. So come on, let's start standing. Okay. Now as the class of 2022, we have achieved this major early milestone in our lives, high school graduation. I'd like for my fellow classmates to join me in giving a round of applause to these people who have lifted us on their shoulders so we could reach this stage today. Now you all may take your seat. I would like to say thank you to everyone who had helped us in every step of the way for us to succeed. The challenges over the past 12 years. To our parents for the 24/7 love and support. Thank you, Mom and Dad. And to our teachers for the guidance. Now, to my fellow graduates, it is not easy to say farewell, but I must do. They say that parting is such a sweet sorrow, but I believe that this is not the end of our acquaintances and friendships. We must go our way to pursue our dreams. I hope that the next time we see each other, the same smile and the same warmth of friendship will be given to each other. My best regards to all my cohorts. Today, as all of our families and friends are gathered here for our farewell ceremony. From here on, we will take different routes to accomplish our future endeavors. This is a day when
We remember all the good moments we have spent here at Miami Valley High School. We take the memories of good times with us and use them as stepping stones from here. After so much hard work, dedication, exertion, and effort, now is the time to say, Hagone do ta kujitego. Once a Mustang, always a Mustang. Ajahe. Sadly, we are ending our ceremony soon. Now I would like to welcome up Mr. Tyler Sagany for our benediction. This man gave me hell for the past couple days.
Thank you. Thank you.